I'm live! Now, this lighting's probably not going to be wonderful. I should probably just stop talking about that on these live videos. But, hello guys! We are going to do some coffee dyeing today, and hopefully if you miss this live video, you can play it back and see how I coffee dye paper. I'm really excited to start a junk journal for myself. And I'm also making a garden journal for someone else. And this, I gotta change the lighting. So, hello, hello, guys. Or I think there's one person here. Sorry, I'm trying to kind of get this set up a little bit better. I was kind of rushing to do this morning. I was asking my son if he would be my assistant. But he had other things on the agenda. He's playing in his room. Okay, hang on. Sorry, guys. Let me see if that's better. It's really bright. Okay, I think that's a little bit better, but I'm not sure why it's so bright right here. That's okay. I think you guys can see what I'm doing. Hello, guys. I hope you guys are having a lovely morning, afternoon. It's 11:25 here. Yeah, I'm going to be coffee dyeing some paper. Okay, Kelly says it's a bit better. I don't know why it's so... I feel like it's focusing on everything back here. This is the only thing about live videos that I'm, like, nervous about, because I can't get it quite set up. Hi! I'm trying to figure out why the lighting is so odd. It's like my face is shining. Maybe if we do it like this. Sorry, guys, just bear with me here. Hello, Tiffany! Really trying to figure out why my face is so bright. Yes, Lane, yep, my son definitely has his own agenda. I was excited, I was like, come be on camera with me, and he's like, no, I just need to build Legos, Mom. We're gonna go out and do some things later, but, yeah. Okay, I don't know what's going on here. Well, might just have to get started. You haven't done coffee dyeing before, Megan? Well, it's really easy. There's a ton of tutorials already on YouTube, which is where I learned. I guess we're just gonna have to get past the fact that my face is, like, brightly shining, and hopefully you can just see what I'm doing. So, yeah, like I said, there's a lot. I'm new to it. I'm pretty new to, like, actual junk journals, too, but I feel like I'm having fun with it, and it's fun to learn with you guys. Okay. So let's just stop worrying about that, and I'm just going to show you what I'm doing. So I am starting off, I have my oven on, and I have it on like the lowest it will go. This is bugging me so bad. It's on 190, so I would just put your oven on the lowest setting, I don't know. And I am using day-old coffee. I saved this from yesterday, and I made it super strong so that the papers would be as dark as possible. You can also use tea, and basically you would just steep, I honestly would steep a handful of tea bags at once, and for the amount of water, I mean, you just want to have, not water, sorry, oh good, this is a little better, huh? You just want to have enough coffee basically to saturate your papers. Okay, so I also have a little casserole dish here that I'm going to use, and I just have some papers that I've kind of saved aside that I've been wanting to dye, and I'm also going to try out dyeing some doilies and a little bag. I was going to pre-make some envelopes, but I didn't get to that. Okay, I also have some parchment paper here. I like to line my baking sheet before I put the papers on, and then when you're done, your parchment paper actually is pretty cool. This is some old parchment paper, which it doesn't really, you can't really see too well, but, I'm actually going to use this to make some, like, glassine bags. Okay, guys, so, I am going to try and move you once again so that you can see my little section here, okay? I promise, I'll get better with time. Bring you down here. Make sure not to drop the phone. I want to make sure that you guys can see what I'm doing. Good thing I was holding my phone there. Okay. That might be okay. Let me tighten that. Okay. I hope you guys are having a lovely day. If you guys aren't home right now, do you stay home or do you just work later in the day? Why are you guys home right now? Okay, I feel like a lot of you might be stay-at-home moms too. Okay, guys. So sorry, this is, I'm not used to this. I'm using a mic stand as my tripod. You chill all day? Hello, I'm having trouble setting up everything, as you can see. Okay, I think what I'm gonna do is turn you around. Oh my gosh, I feel terrible. Okay. This is as good as it's going to get. Oh good, it's your day off. Okay. I don't know. I'm not even gonna mess with it anymore. I will lift things up if you need to see them. You used to teach, but now you stay home with your youngest. Oh, that's awesome. I love staying home. Okay, so I'm just gonna dump my coffee into my dish here. You're too old to work. You don't look too old to work. Ooh, nap, a rare nap. My son, so he's 5 and a half, and he loves sleeping. He still sometimes naps, and he will like come tell me and my husband. He'll just say, I think I'm gonna take a nap, you guys. And I feel like we got lucky in the nap department for sure. Okay. Now, I am going to basically just start dipping my papers in my dish. And maybe if I bring this back a little bit, you guys can actually see it. Okay. I'm going to start with some graph paper. And since this graph paper is really thin, I'm only going to dip this in for a little bit at a time. Okay. Nearing the end of nap stage. Yeah. And another stay-at-home mom. Cool. Okay, so I'm basically just going to... I really want you guys to be able to see this better. Okay. All right. We're just going to hope for the best. Cool, I'm glad that you guys are tuning in on your days off and stuff. It makes me feel special. Okay, so I am just going to use my hands. And I'm basically dunking my papers in. The longer that you let it sit in the coffee, the darker it's going to be. But with thin paper, you do want to be careful. And so I'm just dunking this in, as you can see. I'm going to grab my baking sheet, bring it a little bit closer, and I have it lined with parchment paper just because, I don't know, this is just something I do. I don't think you have to have it lined with parchment paper. Now, when you take it out, you can either make sure that you lay it down super straight if you want kind of just a solid dyed paper look, or you can keep it crumpled up if you want different textures. And now my kitty's meowing really loud. So I do a few layers of paper, and I just learned this the other day. I love taking doilies in between, but you need to do these like pretty quick. You don't want to let this soak too much. And I will put a doily on top of a paper because when that dries, you're going to see that doily shape. And I'm sorry, it's so bright. So I'm just going to go ahead and start dipping in and just layering a few papers on my sheet here. The more papers that you layer on, the longer it's going to take to dry. You can also use a hairdryer to dry these if you want. And sometimes I even go back in and I'll take a little sponge that I have and dip it in the coffee, and then I'll come over to my baking sheet that I already have, and I'll kind of paint some of the coffee on. Yeah, I really like the doily look, but like I said, you have to be pretty careful just because these are really delicate, obviously. I found this paper in an old notebook. It has like this little girl. Is the oven for dry? Yes, the oven is for drying. Sorry, and there's the back of this. My kitchen's like too bright. Anyways, yes, so the oven is for drying the paper. And you are only going to put the paper in the oven on the lowest setting that you can for, I stand right by the oven and it usually takes 7 minutes maybe, but I don't go far. Like, I don't leave the paper in the oven. I got nervous to do this at first. I was like asking my husband, because I was like, is this going to start a pot. Oh, cool. So you're going to start a pot of coffee for this. Sweet. I think I read that you were doing coffee dyeing your laces. Anyways, I asked my husband if I was going to burn the house on fire, and he was like, yeah, no, paper is not going to burn at that low of a temperature. Anyways, so I thought it would be cool to coffee dye some envelopes. Like, they're like little bags. There we go. I promise, guys. I shouldn't keep complaining because I'm, like, new at this, but it bugs me that I can't, like, edit out the parts that are not focused for you guys. It just seems like it's a waste of time. Anyways, so I'm just going to do about 4 pieces here, and then I'm going to pop them in my oven. And let me grab a paper towel. Another thing that you can do is if your papers on your tray are pretty, like, puddled in water. Let me try to see if I can get that to focus for you guys. Not water, sorry, in coffee. I will take a paper towel and kind of blot that up. That's also going to end up leaving some texture. And then I'm going to put these in my oven really quick, and I'll show you one more thing that I like to do that gives us a different texture as well. I keep my oven propped up or propped open because, like I said, I just want to keep an eye on everything. So something else I like to do is take one of these trays, I don't know what you call this, like a cookie thing, I don't know, and I will put a piece of parchment paper over this, and then I will line my coffee dyed papers on this and dry. Are they all stacked on one another? For the ones that I just did, they were stacked. That's going to take a little bit more time, and it is going to change the appearance of how the coffee dyed kind of dries on your papers. When I first started doing this, I would only do a single layer. So I'm just trying something new right now by stacking them, and I've seen plenty of people stack them and it turns out fine. But if you want to do it to where you won't need much drying time, only do a single layer. But as you can imagine, that takes a long time to go through, like, say, 10 pieces of paper. So, you know, just experiment. There's no way to know how it's going to come out for sure. So have fun with it and just don't expect things to, like, you know, look a perfect way, I guess. Okay. Going to take my parchment paper again. And now I am putting it on top of this type of little thing. And this is going to make it dry and have kind of like lines through it. Now you could just take a piece of parchment paper and place it on your actual rack in your oven to get the same thing, but yeah. Oh, and yes, you can let them dry overnight outside. How do I stream on my phone? Apparently some people have the option to do live streams right now, and I believe pretty soon like everyone's going to have the option. I just looked one day and there's a little camera where you upload your videos to, and next to it, it says live. So you can see if you have that option. About a month ago, I had some friends who already had it, and so apparently YouTube is just, like, randomly letting people. I don't know if it has to do with subscriber number, or I really don't know. I love doing graph paper. I think it looks so cool, and these are actually kind of scraps because I messed up on something. Okay. I'm only doing a single layer for this batch, and I'm only going to be able to fit 2 pieces on here, so that's the only bummer, but that's okay. I'm going to take a doily for this batch and place it on top because I really like that. Okay. So yes, you can just leave this out and let it dry overnight, which is probably a really great idea if you're doing this in the evening, and then you could literally line your entire house in coffee dyed papers. And something else is when it's warm, I think I'm going to line dry these because I have a laundry line outside, and I bet the sun will even make them look kind of different. Okay, I'm going to pop these in, and then I'll bring the camera back to my face, and we can chat, and I'll keep an eye on my papers. Sorry, guys. Okay. Make sure. Let me grab the camera. Okay, guys. There we go. So make sure that your, oh boy, it's so bright. I can't think straight. What was I saying? Wow, guys, you're gonna see how confused I get, huh? Oh, make sure that the papers are not touching the edge of your oven, because I did that the first time and one started to get pretty crispy. Okay, so my oven's dirty, don't judge. I'm down here. So you can kind of see, I'm being real careful here. I'm gonna try to show you guys. You want a clothesline? I love having a clothesline. I'm just down here in my groin. Because my son used to wear cloth diapers, and so it was nice to be able to hang everything outside. I actually just made the clothesline, actually. I took like twine and hung it from one side to another outside. So that's all I did. And I think Tiffany just asked if you could use an iron to dry these. I have seen people do that, and I have never done it. My husband would probably not want me to be using our iron on something like that, because he irons all of his clothes and probably wouldn't want me to ruin it. I don't know if it ends up getting ruined, but I would love to try things out like that for you guys. I just have to be a little bit more prepped, because I don't want to keep you on here for like an hour. Okay. Not that I don't have the time, I'm just, yeah, no one, okay. So these are still super damp. I really got this first batch wet, and whoops, that one is okay down there. So we're just gonna let those dry a bit. The other thing I'm hoping to do today is, you love your clothesline. Oh, you live in California. Oh, so nice and warm. I bet it's warm right there right now. Ooh! Melody just said she would maybe try her dehydrator for the doilies. That's an awesome idea. Yeah, I like that. And then Kelly said I should look for an iron at, I think you said like at a secondhand kind of thing. That's a good idea. I would love to have a better system of being able to do these much quicker, but I am needing to go through a pile here, because I am finally wanting to get started on my junk journal, my garden junk journal, and like I keep mentioning 100 times, I'm also making one for someone else, and this person doesn't actually know they're getting it, it's a gift. So yeah, I need to go through, I have a pile that I have been stacking up that has tons of just different things, and I need to go through and actually start picking out what I want, and I need to start creating signatures for the junk journal. I was kind of thinking, I know a lot of you want to see junk journal like tutorials and whatnot, and since I'm going to be working on one for myself, maybe I can do these live streams every so often, and even if I can't show you a full tutorial on something, maybe I can figure out a good way to set up my phone and show you like what stage I'm at, and I can explain how I did it. Honestly, a lot of junk journaling is really, it's really easy to put together. You just need to know how to do it, and there are so many tutorials on YouTube. The only thing I find is that I have a hard time finding a tutorial that actually shows all of the steps. So I know that it would be nice to get one out there. And someone just asked what the point of a junk journal is, and for me it's memory keeping. A lot of people also use junk journals as a way to journal. I actually was just watching a video where someone had a dream junk journal. I imagine they write down their dreams. So, and I have I think like a couple junk journal flip throughs that are finished junk journals where I used it as memory keeping on my channel. So I can try to find that video. I'm gonna check my papers now. And I do have to go in just a few minutes, but I want to at least show you the final product. This is so funny to do a live video because, okay, these are all still really wet. So I could definitely turn up my oven. It's on 190 right now. Or, let's see, can you guys see, let's see here, if you can see that doily, it's almost like it's almost melting into the other papers, but once everything dries, I will be able to pull it up, although it kind of looks cool like that. So that's another thing about doing coffee dyeing, is that you just never know what you're going to end up with when you product a junk journal. I didn't read that comment. I think it said when am I going to get a junk journal tutorial, maybe? I do already have a tutorial on my channel where I put together a junk journal, just like the base of it, not decorating it. I can show you guys right now. I've showed it a couple times, but I know that everyone is like on here at separate times. So, okay, I just pulled one down real quick. Let me see if I can flip the camera around. Okay, so to me, this is a junk journal. I have a tutorial showing you how to make this, but I'll show you what it looks like once I was all complete. Now, a lot of people actually construct their junk journals with junk, which is the name. And what I mean by junk is like old envelopes, old papers, old things, and they use those as the pages. I do mine a little bit different. I use designed paper and just random papers and things that I collect, things that I like, and then I actually decorate my pages with the junk, with the things that I'm collecting. I keep old menus when we go out to eat. I keep all kinds of things. Junk journals typically have lots of envelopes. See in here, this is an envelope here, and I have some bracelets like that we, let's see, one's from Vlogger Fair, one's from, I don't know, you know, wherever else. Yeah. Oh, that's okay, Sonia. No, your English is fine. The thing is the comments, when they show up on the screen, they go away pretty quick, and it's hard to read them. You like the idea? Yeah. Like, I even document times when we are sick. I write letters to my son in my junk journals, and I make one of these every single month. I started out doing memory keeping on my photo books. I don't want to make you guys dizzy, but I'm going to walk over here. And these are photo books right here, and if you're familiar with Shutterfly, you just make these. These are a digital book, and I made one every single month since my son has been alive, and he's 5 and a half, so you can imagine I have tons. Before this, I used to actually do scrapbooking, 12 by 12 scrapbooks. Oh, yeah, I love writing letters to my son. Yeah, so this is just an idea. I mean, and to me, these were not as creative as I wanted it to be, because you're doing it digital, and you're just doing pictures, and there was a son, or a picture of my son's booty. He probably doesn't want me to show that, but, yeah, so you can see this is just a really easy way, but just to give you an idea of how I used to do memory keeping. But when he was little, I had no time. You know, I was always holding him and whatnot, so this was quick, it was easy, and it was what I was able to do. And yeah, he made this funny face, and almost every cover of the books that I have here, I would put one of his photos where he's doing that face. Like, almost all of these have that face, and it's so funny because even when he was older, I would have him do this little face. So, anyways, guys, I'm turning you back around, and I'm just gonna check again. This is taking maybe I just feel like it's taking longer because I'm like filming, but I did get these like pretty wet, and like I mentioned, the first batch I layered a bunch, and I didn't do that the first time. So, okay, this one's almost done. So let's try to see here. So I hope that you guys can see that. And as you can see, it's hard to see the actual details on camera, but there are like little lines. And there you go. So I love the crinkle too. Now, if you are someone who wants your paper to be flat, what you can do is once it's dry, you can place it under like some heavy books or something like that. Thank you, Tiffany. Yeah, it's fun, and okay, I hope I can show you this doily one. Let me try to flip my camera again. Great angle. Can you see where the doily was right there? I think that looks so cool. And then I'll show you the actual doily too. I didn't know this is live. I guess I need to watch when it loads to see the beginning. Yeah, you do, but you know what? You probably didn't miss out much. I'm new to the live videos, and it took me a little bit to it took me a little bit to get everything set up to where you guys could see very well. But all we were doing is coffee dyeing. If you're just jumping on, I was just sharing how to coffee dye paper, or how I do. I'm not an expert. I'm pretty new to it. Basically, you just soak your paper in coffee and dry it. There are several ways you can dry it. Oven, a hair dryer, someone mentioned an iron, just leaving it out overnight. There's really no wrong or right way to do this. Just have fun with it, guys. And yeah, I think that's all I'm going to show for today. We are getting ready to go hang out with my son and I. So yeah, and unless anyone has some questions, and thank you for being patient with me while I try to figure out the camera. I definitely try to figure out a better way so that lighting's okay and so that I can easily move the camera around. You've done tea dyeing before? Fun. I definitely want to try tea dyeing so that I can see what kind of a difference there is. And yeah, I will definitely be doing some more junk journal videos for you guys. I am almost done finishing the DIY bullet journal video. I stayed up really late last night to finish that. I'm not quite finished, but I have to do a voiceover. So, yeah, guys, I hope that you have a lovely day. Let me know if you try it, and I'll see you guys later, okay? You've never seen the doily look? Hi to the other Tiffany. You're welcome, Megan. Thanks for being with me. You guys are awesome. I love you. Bye.